Let's bring in Republican Senator from Colorado, Cory Gardner. Senator, thanks so much for joining me. We heard Republicans take some shots there at Secretary Clinton, no pun intended, at the NRA convention. The RNC also wasting no time releasing this ad on the heels of the news that Secretary Clinton is running. Let's just watch a quick snippet.
Hillary Clinton has some explaining to do.
Used her personal email account to conduct official business.
Wanted to reset relations with Russia.
Not really working out well.
Potentially catastrophic move for Hillary Clinton.
Taking millions of dollars from foreign governments.
Pretty sinister seeming ad. The Republican Party must be pretty worried about Secretary Clinton to be attacking her so quickly.
Well, I think this is just defining what the American people are already believing about Hillary Clinton. The fact is, several years ago, she ran a TV commercial against President, or then candidate Obama. Who do you want answering the call? And I think what we're seeing here is defining Hillary Clinton on the phone call that she's been answering, the phone call of hiding her attempted emails at the State Department, the phone call that she's received from foreign donors to her foundations. And so I think the RNC and others are right to say, hey, you know what? She's the nominee. She's going to be the nominee. They've rolled out the red carpet for her. Now let's talk about what she has done during her time as Secretary of State and the things that she's done recently. Really a question whether or not she has the ability and the record to be President of the United States.
What do you think is her greatest vulnerability, and what do you think is her greatest strength as a candidate?
In terms of greatest strength, I think universal name ID. People know who she is. They know the Clinton family. President Clinton was a very popular president, remains a very popular president to this day. She is successful in her own right, no doubt about that, as a senator, successful as Secretary of State, but again, disagreeing with many of the policies that she pursued, not only as senator and as Secretary of State.
I don't have to tell you how important the women's vote is, because you won your Senate seat partly because of it. You're also a father of two girls, baby girl just born in December, yeah. Which might drive home the historic nature of the Clinton candidacy even more. Assuming that your nominee is a male, which I think is a safe assumption, do you think his running mate needs to be a woman?
I think we need to have the best running mate, vice president candidate who will assume the duties of the presidency if something should happen. We always pray and hope that it doesn't happen. But the fact is, we need somebody who is best qualified, be that a woman, be that a man, somebody who can do the best job for the American people in that great time of tragedy that it would be.
Let's turn to foreign policy. You're on the Senate Foreign Relations Committee. You just returned from a trip overseas. You visited Kuwait, Israel, Iraq, Jordan, Afghanistan. I know you have serious concerns about this Iran framework deal for their nuclear program. Your fellow freshman Senator Tom Cotton told me that airstrikes against Iran's nuclear facilities would be preferable to implementing this deal. Do you agree?
What I agree with is the need for a good deal, and I think that's something that Senator Cotton has been very firm on, whether it's his communications to leaders around the world that any bad deal could be undone by Congress. But I think here's the ultimate desire of all of us, and that's to make sure that we have a good deal that eliminates nuclear capabilities, not just slowing it down. This president has gone to amazing lengths to try to secure international legitimacy for the Iranian deal. But we should start with domestic legitimacy. And that begins next week with the passage of the Corker-Menendez bill out of the Foreign Relations Committee in the Senate and on to the full Senate for a vote. So this, as we have this negotiation, as we talk about what the details of this framework will really be, I think it's important to understand that we need congressional oversight, congressional feedback, congressional approval to secure that domestic legitimacy.
Senator Cory Gardner of Colorado, thank you so much. Have fun at that Rockies game.
Hey, thank you very much. You know, things are going well so far. Let's just hope we keep it that way.
All right.
Early on.
Thank you so much.